Everybody, this is Kyle, and here is my song, I Ain't Special. I wrote this song in 2013, and actually when I first wrote it, I was gonna rap it. Kinda in a style of Sublime, or if you know the more contemporary artist, Wax. I really like that vibe of playing guitar and rapping, even though at that particular time I wasn't even really singing yet. So as I started to learn how to sing, I revisioned a song and kind of like talk sung it and had a chorus that you could sing. Now this was early on when I was singing, and when I recorded this, I may have been singing just a few months because, like I tell people in comments, if you think that you can't sing, yeah, you can. You can learn how to do it. It's similar to talking, of course, but the way you use your voice when you talk versus when you sing, it's very different. And if it makes me sound different, it can make you sound different too.
Making a Midwest feel fresh with alibaba in the 40 thieves. Paul revere, party fighting up their sleeves. They expanded my musical taste. Metallica, anthrax, moshing up the place. Straight in the suburbs were NWA. Eazy, suburbs, platter was on the way. Then came a band that blew my mind. Jello science could make a seeing man blind. In the high school signal to change. James addiction, alt rock would go to long range. Special, I'm just me. Same rope goes for everybody. Each lab's got its own recipe. Mixin', making your history. I ain't special, I'm just me. Same rope goes for everybody. Each lab's got its own recipe. Mixin', making your history. Escape rock started to be called grunge. The flannel wore a Northwest with a needle to plunge. Nirvana in chains while we're in mud, honey. Healing gear hat and East Coast Fugazi. 311 drop, some reggaeton. Adding funk to punk to shake some bones. The president's singing about peaches and kitty. Green Day always has a ballad that's pretty. Industrial club night with TKK. Lords of acid and ministry. 9-inch nails hit a hole in your head. Down in it was a new place to trip. Beasties are playing at loud and loud. Sabotage was the anthem, make it seem thrive. I ain't special, I'm just me. Same rope goes for everybody. Each life's got its own recipe. Mixing, making your history. I ain't special, I'm just me. Same rope goes for everybody. Each life's got its own recipe. Mixing, making your history. A blur, a song to yell and woo while the rhythm chills. Rage peaked and had a fight with rebels. System of a down was fighter sugar spells. Clubs were banging some sandstorm beats. Zombie nation had us on our feet. Lamb of God has an edge that's brutal. MCA left a hole that will never fill. Mad respect for music's island home. Jamaica dub wise rise to Zion. I am what makes me, all by myself without nobody. Except for all the music of the world, including everyone on one and who I haven't told. I ain't special, I'm just me. Same road goes for everybody. Each life's got its own recipe. Mixing, making your history. Special, I'm just me. Same road goes for everybody. Each life's got its own recipe. Mixing and making your history. I ain't special, I'm just me. 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 I ain't ain't special, I'm just me. I ain't special, I'm just me. I ain't special, I'm just me.
What I was trying to do with this song, and as a songwriter, I'm always trying to tell a story, and this was early on in my songwriting as well. I wanted to go through musical influences for me personally that led me to where I was, because I didn't see myself becoming a singer-songwriter. I didn't see myself becoming a singer, for that matter. So the song is set up in different sections. Verse one is talking about high school. Verse 2 is talking about college, and verse 3 is talking about after college, like when I started teaching and things. So let's take a look at verse 1, talking about the Beastie Boys, and that is probably my most favorite band of all time. So this verse is talking about the Beastie Boys, and you're going to see that recurring theme going along. You have Metallica, Anthrax, and Slayer, part of the Big Four. Sorry, I didn't mention Megadeth. But we get into NWA, Eazy, and there is a nod to another one of my favorite bands of all time, the Dead Kennedys, with Jello Biafra, the singer. And of course, Jane's Addiction. What I was trying to do with the chorus is have some sort of personal anthem, because I don't think that I'm special. I don't think that I'm a big deal, and that's always a struggle, you know, as I make YouTube videos or write songs or perform. I'm like, anybody can do what I'm doing. Yeah, I might have some talent when it comes to guitar or different things, you know. I'm a nerdy dude, but I'm not really that special. I'm just a person doing what I can, trying to make something out of what I got going on in my head. So before this becomes a free therapy session for Kyle, let's look at verse 2. Verse 2 is talking about college, and for me, that grunge hit. Now, for a couple years, I've been hearing about skate rock, and honestly, I didn't like it. It was kind of loose. The guitars were too distorted and down-tuned, and, you know, bands like Mudhoney and stuff. I mean, it's cool. I could appreciate the riffage and stuff, but I was more interested in East Coast punk and some of the metals from the crossover bands that were out at the time. But going through the verse, you know, we got Nirvana, of course, Ian and Guy from Fugazi, 311, President of the United States of America, another one of my favorites, Green Day, of course, and they, at the time, they always had that pretty ballad song. It was kind of a joke. So I started to move into electronic music. I have Thrill Code Cult, Lords of Acid, another one of my hugely favorite bands. Ministry, Nine Inch Nails. And of course, I had to mention the Beastie Boys again. In the 90s, when the Beasties, you know, Pollywog Stew was released, and I was like, oh, hey, this is cool to hear what they used to do. But when they started to switch from hip-hop to punk and go back and forth in a set on an album, that was like the best of everything at the time. Getting to verse 3, it starts off, after school life became a blur. Yes, that's a mention of the band. Song 2, you got Rage Against the Machine, System of a Down. Club music, again, a mention, getting into electronic. There in the late 90s, a lot of us punks, former punks, I guess, punks that were aging, looked at electronic music as the evolution of the underground, things that were going on in Europe and the UK. That was such a cool and vibrant scene at the time. And yeah, the late 90s, early 2000s, I DJ'd a bit and produced some electronic music. And let me know if you want me to react to that. Some of it is horribly bad because I had almost no equipment. I had like a $100 software program and did the best that I could. And anyway, getting back to the lyrics, we have Sandstorm and Zombie Nation for club music. And of course, there was a ton of other stuff then around the turn of the century. Mention of some other music too. Had some students that introduced me to Lamb of God in the early 2000s. MCA passing away, of course, have to mention the Beasties again. discovering old Jamaican music was a big deal to me, and that really had a huge impact on me is the singer-songwriter in these early years thinking about, hey, what do I want to do? What do I want to sound like? And I love that energy of some of those like old Trojan recordings and things like that. So if you're in a Jamaican culture, Jamaican music, you probably know what I'm talking about with those Trojan recordings. So here at the end, I'm wrapping everything up and reflecting it to myself, reflecting internally, externally, and I have another big nod to the Beasties. I am what makes me me, that's all Kyle. But then a Beastie Boys reference because it's like the Beastie Boys were such a huge influence on me that they deserve half of the thought there. So a huge nod taken from Paul Revere. All by myself without nobody, because sometimes when you're making your own music, you just gotta do it your own way. You gotta learn. You gotta give it a try. And to me, that's the whole idea of this song. I'm not special. The only thing that makes me different than anybody watching this that doesn't do what I do is I actually try to do it. I put something out there. And honestly, it's that simple. The only difference, the only thing that might make me slightly more special in someone else's eyes is that I actually try and put something out there. And that's a message I, share with my students and share with other people that if you want to do something, you got to do something. Let's leave it at that.